Jeff, what's up, Jeff? He says, do we have to worry about stock photo copyright issues when posting to social media like Twitter, the same way we do with their website? I don't know, Jeff. I wish I did. I wish I had a definitive answer. Maybe somebody else on here knows.
Anybody? I had some issues when it comes to posting on Facebook. So yeah, like short answer is yeah, because I had to take down an amazing ad that was performing super well, just because, you know, I was lazy and I didn't check the stock photos stuff. So the actual owner of the photo contacted me and say, hey dude, you need to take off the ad. And I lost the entire social proof and everything on the Facebook side of things. So yeah, short answer is yes, because you can get in trouble. Like no matter, it doesn't really matter if you're using it on Twitter, Google. Like Google, maybe you would have a bigger exposure because you're being indexed. But on Twitter, people can still see it, right? So I think it's just a matter of, you know, photos are still an asset. So it's like using, I don't know, a piece of a song, right? Or a piece of a yeah, movie, something like that. All of that is copyrighted. So you need to have that in mind, no matter what where you're using it. When you're doing it on your website, you're a bit more exposed because anyone can get access to that. While in Twitter, it's not the case. But just to avoid issues, I would say, don't do it. You know. Plus, there are so many deals, and you know, having stock photos is like has become really, really cheap. If you go to AppSumo, for example, you can get deals like, I don't know, for 100 photos for $10 or something like that. You know, so it's not even worth the trouble of getting through it. So,
yeah. Yeah, and usually for my clients, what I have them do is I use stockfresh.com as that's our primary stock photo site. And so I just have my clients go set up an account where I set it up for them in their name, and then I send them the login details, and then they go in and fund it by just purchasing credits. And we usually purchase 100 credits at a time. I think it's $79 or something like that at StockFresh. It's not bad. It's decent. And so, you know, every couple of months or so, my curators, my VAs who are doing all of the content marketing for my clients will contact me and say, hey, we need this account refilled. And I'll just contact the client and say, hey, I need you to add another $100, refill the account, with credits. And that's it. And that's how it works. And that's just to be safe. And that's because I've been hit with extortion letters from Getty Images and their various subsidiaries, and I've had to pay fines, copyright, you know, fine settlement fees, basically, for not having each client having their own licenses. In other words, even if I had my own account for my marketing agency with stock photos, if I published those stock photos on clients' websites, the client needs to have a license for that photo, even though I did it on their behalf. I was the license holder, not the client. And I've had to pay settlement fees for copyright infringement issues for client sites that they received the extortion letter, but I paid it on their behalf because it was my fault for not having them set up properly. And that's why I talk about that again, in the content kingpin training that I was just talking about. I go into great detail about all of that because it's very, very important. So I would follow Hernan's advice about social media and really try to have proper licensing for photos that you're using.
Yeah. Yeah, I would do that too. And for example, there are some websites that there's explicitly like royalty free photos, like Flickr, for example. You can search for royalty free photos. Then I think unsplash.com, which is UNSPLASH. SH.com and splash.com. There's another called pixabay.com. Those are all royalty free photos, but you're limited to what you can find over there, right? So sometimes for ads, it will work, but if I'm looking for a specific way or specific photo that will convey specific message that I want to, you know, that I want to send, then it wouldn't work. So I'll need to go out and actually purchase the picture. And it's specifically important with social media. Like Twitter has become super, super visual. If you go through the Twitter app on mobile, it's super visual, you know? So photos play a big role.
Yeah.